guys, it's Jen. What is up? Welcome back to the channel for a brand new speed build. So I decided to go and switch up our intro for today's video just simply because in episode number 46 of The Four Mans, I got a whole bunch of tweets on Twitter of people literally gagging over what YouTube was translating my intro into. And that tweet alone reached almost 2K freaking likes, which is insane to me. I honestly don't get it, but it is quite funny. So if you guys are interested in checking out what the translation was, you can go ahead and look at the tweet. It is on my Twitter still. You might have to go and scroll a little bit through my media, but you will find it and you will see exactly what they turned my sweet, sweet, sweet intro into. It's horrible. And for that reason alone, I feel like that is probably why a lot of my videos are getting demonetized, because that is certainly not what I said. Like, I don't even know where they pulled that out of. Anyway, so, and also not to mention the whole, like, hey, it's Jen kind of a gig. It just feels a little more authentic than saying the other thing that I was saying. Like, that's almost forbidden at this point. Like, I'm almost scared to utter those words. Like, seriously, not even kidding. So, I don't know. Let me know how you like the new intro. Let me know how you would feel if I was to change it in the comments down below. But today we are here with another apartment build, which is so exciting. I have been living for apartment builds lately, and I don't know why. Like, for the longest time, I hated building in apartments. I hated them in general. I thought they were trash. I literally wanted to throw them down the garbage disposal. But ever since I created a Taylor's apartment, I've genuinely just been loving creating apartments. And I want to do many, many of them. I think the biggest issue that I personally have when it comes to apartments is figuring out the layout, because there's only so many ways that you can lay out an apartment before someone comes for your neck and then automatically assumes you're trying to copy somebody else. And I've had that happen, and it's unfortunate, you know? So that's the only, like, part that kind of freaks me out a little bit. But other than that, they are just so fun, because for me personally, when it comes to branching out and trying new styles, or, you know, even going into depth with the clutter and stuff, it's just an easier way to kind of contain it into a small space and not feel so overwhelmed with having to do it on a grand scale such as a house or whatever. So it's a nice little stepping stone to greater horizons, I suppose. So when it comes to Nixon's apartment, I don't know if I told you that we were creating Nixon's apartment yet, but I did dub this video as a single dad apartment, which it totally could be, but just keep in mind that this apartment is with Nixon Foreman in mind. I wanted it to kind of stay not like super duper cluttered, because financially I didn't have the funds to really go balls to the wall. However, I did want it to look lived in. So there are little like aspects to it that definitely, you know, give you more of like a home aesthetic, a little more of a lived in vibe, which is kind of cool. And again, I wanted it to reflect his personality, and he's kind of like a tough sim to read. I feel like when it comes to like personal style, he loves sports. He kind of leans more towards a modern palette with a twist of some Brindleton Bay vibes, if you get my drift, because I feel like that is where he spent the vast majority of his life. So when it comes to like his personal aesthetic and style, he is greatly influenced by their old house in Brindleton. So yeah, I wanted to keep it kind of like, I don't know, more of like an urban vibe too. I loved the exposed brick. I also really, really, really love these solid walls with no trimming at all. I feel like they definitely blend in very nicely when it comes to apartments, because you have like these really big walls, and usually I would steer clear of those wallpapers, but I'm starting to find that they just look amazing and I'm actually getting a lot of use out of them. So for the kitchen, I was totally tempted to switch out the counters, but this is the original kitchen that the apartment came with, and I'll tell you guys a little bit about how we got into this bad boy in case you have no clue how we got here. So I wanted to take them out. I wanted to gut them and put in something else, but I was determined to make them blend in with the rest of the unit. So the whole idea of how Nixon came to live here is essentially Maddox actually used to live here, and June used to live here before that. And when June lived here, she actually owned this apartment. She sold it to a company that leases, and they have been leasing to Maddox and Nixon ever since. And so when Maddox left, he left in good terms, and the landlord actually renovated the apartment. He changed up the layout. He added in a kitchen. He also put in a spare bedroom, because a lot of families have been moving into San Myshuno lately. And so for Nixon to come in and kind of undo all that, it isn't really logical. And also, if you guys want to download the original version of this apartment with just the kitchen, kitchen and the bathroom you can. It is on the gallery at Gen 2 606. I think that would be a kind of a fun way to like move in with your Sims and decorate it for yourself and kind of give that feeling of actually moving into an apartment versus like downloading one that's already pre-furnished. But I will have the furnished version available if you guys are also interested in that as well. So let's go and talk about how amazing it is that Nixon is slowly but surely getting back onto his feet. There was a time that I was so scared for Nixon. I was honestly petrified for where his life was going to take him. I wasn't sure. Like, I have contemplated so many different storylines, you guys. It's really crazy because there is a lot that goes on behind the scenes that you don't see. I ultimately wasn't expecting for him to bounce back, so to speak, and get his ish together, but he did. He persevered. And ever since he was a teeny tiny little baby, he has always been so damn strong. But he also feels really deeply, and sometimes I feel like that is truly his Achilles heel. So anyways, I wanted to go and put up a little bit of just like random artwork and stuff because Finn loves to create art. She loves to create crafts, and I can imagine her always giving them to like Nixon and him proudly displaying them on his walls. Also used a bunch of stuff from Debug. I found this really cool painting here, or like picture, that was kind of the influence for the color palette for the second room, which idealistically, it's perfect for Grayson. Not so perfect for his two toddlers in child that come over, but also, I don't know if you guys have noticed, perfect timing. We have a little closet back here, and I don't really see a lot of people using a closet space as a closet. I feel like there are a lot of things that just kind of stick out, don't really have a true place to be, such as like the decoration box from Seasons, and then also being able to, in this instance, put away like the little potty that the toddlers use, and just maybe some miscellaneous items here in the closet that Nixon can reach for when he needs them. I don't feel like a lot of people do that, and I feel like that is a really good space to utilize, because also, what was I gonna do with that? Like, I had no idea what to do with this little one by three room. You know, it's not big enough to really add anything else in, and then it would kind of like crop in to the entryway, which I love an entryway into an apartment. I like how everything is like segregated. To be honest, I'm really enjoying this layout. I think it's awesome. And also, the bedrooms are a very nice size. So naturally, if you really did want to use this for like a family, you totally could. I know a lot of you guys are saying how this would be perfect for when the kids come over to visit Nixon, which obviously that is going to happen a lot more frequently now that he actually has a place where his kids could come over. However, I really do feel like if we got bunk beds, it would be a lot easier for me to turn this into a room for kids, because then that way I would have a sleeping place for everyone. But at the moment, I really just don't have that capability, and I was super duper inspired with this palette by that painting, and so I naturally kind of gravitated towards creating a room for Grayson, which honestly wouldn't be the worst thing. I would love for him to come and stay with his dad, or at least come and visit him, so that that way they could kind of build their relationship, and maybe possibly we could even, I don't know, work on some of those things that are just bothering him, because he really is going through a very tough time in his life right now. I mean, can we just add him to the list? Because every freaking foreman that I know of right now is going through something, I swear. Anyways, long story short, you guys, I wanted to very briefly, before we wrapped up this speed build, touch base on Nixon's New Year's resolution. So if you didn't watch the last episode, pause, go watch it, then come back to me, because I might actually spoil it for you. Nixon's New Year's resolution was to find a significant other. Now, I'm going to say significant very loosely, because in my personal opinion, that would be just him kind of playing the field, dating around a little bit, seeing what's out there, because it has been years, and I mean years, since he has even considered being with someone. Obviously, he still wears his wedding ring. So in the comments down below, tell me who you'd envision Nixon's future whatever to be. Let me know. I'm kind of curious, like, what would their traits be, what would their temperament be, what would they look like? I want to know, and maybe possibly I could create Nixon's dream girl based on the comments. I think that would be actually really freaking cool. So with that said, you guys, I'm gonna go ahead and wrap up this video here. I hope that you all enjoyed, and if you did, you know what to do, boo. Don't forget to go ahead and comment, rate, and subscribe. Let me know what you guys think in the comments down below, where the sun does not shine, and I will see you all next time. Bye, guys. Won't you kiss us in the morning light? Wanna be next to you every night.
just get